on troubleshooting terms, working on balance, on dizziness, and on control. So we started with the idea of squatting, so finding a space that you then
leave your head watching as you turn your body, and then turn your head fast quickly around to finish it, to look at it again as you finish your turn. So finding something at eye level that's easy to find. So that helps with the dizziness, and practice, unfortunately, does the rest. The other thing we talked about was the idea of pivot turns. So when we pivot, we want to make sure that we're, you know, we're moving like a penguin, in which we don't center legs everywhere. It's all kind of together. And we want to make sure that as we pivot, every step is 180, 180, 180, 180, and we land on the foot that's closer to the air, to the direction that we're going. Then we put it together for squatting. So if I'm squatting area, I would go da, 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 da. But as follows, we want to squat the wall because the wall does not move, whereas people do. We put this into a move, which was like this, the outside turn. It went like this. One, two, trip, pose, step, the leader's turn. And we talk about the back that follows. You want to give yourself plenty of space between your hand and your forearm, and your head, kind of around the forehead level. And it's your job to try to keep this position, to keep her on the correct axis. If you're a shorter lead with the taller follow, get a little closer, or maybe if the height difference is too much, then you might want to try to get the head move. Then we went straight into prep side. So we talked about making sure that follows just hanging back a little bit when you get prepped, so that you can actually feel how big of a prep you're getting. And making sure that you're not taking such a big step that you're falling, out of, I don't know if I can show this on video, but that you're falling out of connection. And these being able to determine how big a prep size you want to get your partner to turn in the amount that you want to turn. And then we started talking, and we applied that for to a reverse whip, because you only need her to turn half a turn and a very slow one. So it's a really tiny prep, because the minute you give yourself too much, then she's going to turn too much, and then you're
above the line. Then we talk about turns of direction. So if you want your ball to go down the spot, you want to keep leading that lead down that spot, or if you want her to turn on the spot, you're going to leave her back down that spot.